Hello everybody, welcome back to Terraformacraft. Now in today's episode, hopefully we're going to be making a saw. I've been exploring and I found some more copper. Nothing in like ore form at the moment, just nuggets on the ground. But hopefully we'll have enough to actually make another tool, because I found two or three pieces in a different area and it looks like there's quite a few here. That was 3, 4, 5, 6, so... yeah, we've definitely got enough, because we had 30 from the cave, and I found at least two or three on the floor, on the ground, so that's another 6, so that's it's more than 100 units, so we should be alright with another tool. I probably sound really different, really weird at the moment, because, ooh, and another one. Because I'm sleepy, I just woke up, had some coffee, and I'm recording. So yeah. Probably going to be a lot of derps in this episode, but we're going to try and get through it. Also, I have... oh, there's another one, I think. There's a lot of copper here. I have marked it on my mini-map. There was people asking what mini-map I'm using. It's the same one I've been using for 3 seasons. Ray's mini-map for 1.7.10. I will eventually get some links in the descriptions for you. But I just haven't had time to put them all in. Also, I have added NEI and Code Chicken Core, because you need Code Chicken Core to actually make NEI work. And the TFC add-on for NEI. So you need base NEI, TFC add-on, and Code Chicken Core just to get NEI to work. So now we have... oh, it would help if I wasn't searching for something. Yes, we have 13 pages of NEI stuff showing us how to make all the things, good. So, there was a lot of stuff added from the add-on mods, which I didn't really have that much of an idea how to make, and it would mean just keep going back and forth between the websites, the TFC forums, to find the crafting recipes and stuff, but now we got it. One of the coolest things, I think, is the these outline blocks. Basically, they added a new mode with a certain add-on mod. They added a new mode to the chisel where you can do like outlines, different kinds of outlines. Really cool. We'll get to use that. And also this one, you have a plank planer, and then you can make these plane planks, and they make these weird block planks. Yes, compass, clock, gears, casing glue for making sticky pistons. You can make pistons as well. Does require redstone and iron, so might be a while before we get those. But one cool thing I know we can make today is we had these deer tendons from killing deers, obviously, and you can use those to make sinew fiber, and then you can use the sinew fiber to make sinew string. You can use that to make sinew bowstring, and that you can make a longbow. You do need a bow limb, but that is literally just a knife, a stone knife you can use, and a log, which gives you a bow limb. So awesome. We can make a bow. I'm not sure if it's gonna be working with just regular stone arrows. We might actually have to make some bronze arrows, but hopefully it works with stone ones. I'm not too sure what these coils are used for. For making links and then making chain. Basically, that's for making chain armor, which does look quite cool. Yeah. Cool. So I think that works best against slashing. I'm not too sure. Anyway, oh, it's dark. Okay. Food. I did also find some maize and some more soybeans. So we got a decent amount of food. And also in today's episode, I think we're gonna try and set up a farm somewhere. Because we are gonna need to set a farm up as soon as possible, really, because it does take a long, long time for crops to grow. So, well, some crops grow really quickly, some take a long time to grow. So I think we're going to set it up as close to the second mountain as possible, because we will eventually be moving along to that one. think we're not that far away from the base, actually. Yeah, I think I saw... Yeah, that's our base, just there. Cool. So, hopefully... Well, actually, no. We should definitely have enough copper to make another tool. And then once we get a saw, we can do all kinds of carpentry stuff, making chests and doors and stuff like that. And... what they're called, support beams, so then we can actually go and do some proper caving instead of just looking for stuff that's in the side of walls. And then, did I hear a spider? No. And then once we've got that, we can actually, hopefully, we'll go back to that copper mine and try and get some more copper and make a prospector's pick, because that's definitely going to be needed as well. And I also need some more storage because I'm running out very quickly. Cool. Can we break these? We can. For now, I'm just going to put these down. So we can clean this up and we'll start cooking up some copper because it will take a long time. You can go in there for now. Also, log piles. I forgot to tell people how to make log piles. Basically, shift right-click on the ground will turn a log into a log pile. You can hold a full stack in there. So, let's just put some stuff away. Also, killed some more deer. I think two more. Just to get some more sinew... Pardon me, some more sinew things. Just in case we didn't have enough. This can go in there. This one. Actually, no, I need that. That's my door. Cool. That wasn't clever. Because now I need one. I need an empty vessel. We'll take this one. So, we have 10... Wow, that's good. We got 10 nuggets straight away. We can save the two. What am I doing? We can save those two poor ones and try and use that a different time. Is there anything else I want to cook in this fire pit kiln thing? Might be worth making a prospector's pick mold at this point. If I can remember how to use it, but that's one good thing about any eye. You can just search for mold. Aha. Oh, it's just M-O-L-D. Okay, weird. Prospector's pick looks like this. So it's one there. And one, two, three, four, one, two, three. Cool. Halberd. Hello. Uses. Can we make a copper halberd? We can. I might actually make this instead of a sword. Maybe. And we can make bolts. We could actually make some copper arrows. Cool. Actually, no, that's for crossbows, isn't it? Bolts. Shovel. Hoe. We don't need a hoe at this point. Chisel or an axe might be the next thing we need, or a weapon. Actually, a weapon would be good. I don't think we'd be able to make a hammer or a halberd at this point, or a scythe would be cool. There's so many tools, so many tools. First, let's do the prospector's pick. So, one there. Go along and two down. Sweet. Also, I need to go and get some more clay because I'm running out. Did I store any in this thing? I didn't. Oh, I need to seal that because we've got food in there. Take these out because we need that. What should we make? Chisel, sword. Or halberd. Okay, I think I'm just going to go with the standard sword for now. If we want to make some more adventurous weapons, we can do that at another point in time. So, sword, I believe, is just like this. What was that? It just... I think that was like a poignard. It's one of the new things, yeah. Like a mini sword. New things from an add-on mod, not new things in standard Terraformacraft. We need more straw. And also more logs. I'm quite curious as to what the poignard does. Because all of the different weapons have like different traits, different things they do. Cool, so as usual, put your straw in, put your logs on top. And in fact, I need some more torches, so I'm going to do it the quick way. And we'll get that lit. So what is the next thing, ow, that we need to do? We can make a bow while we wait, I guess. So, deer tendons, we need a hammer. Stone hammer, I believe, will work. So let's make one of those. Hammerhead, need a stick, and we're good. So, oh crap. Guess what I just realized? We need to put these fibers 3x3. So we need to make a crafting bench. So we can't actually make that until we have a saw. Okay. So we're going to have to wait for that to finish. Can't really adventure too far away, because if this finishes, we have to turn it into a tool as soon as possible, really, because if you don't, it will, the metal will go back to solid, it'll cool down and go back to solid, and then you have to cook it again to actually use it again. What's our diet like? Fruit, grain, dairy, so we can eat some grain, I guess. Where's that maize? I'd rather save the wheat, to be honest, so we can use that to breed animals. I think we can use maize as well, but maize... I don't know, I'd rather just eat it. Okay, let's also make a hoe while we're here. So you take two off the bottom, one off the top. This is how I do it. You can do it different ways, and that is the pattern you need. I'm going to need some more sticks as well. Cool. While we wait, I guess we can go and see what this metal is. There's two different ores in the side of this. That is bismuth. I know that, and I'm not too sure what this is. I believe it's limonite, which is... No, it's coal. Okay. Okay, that's... I guess that's good to have, so we can mine a bit of this while we wait. But bismuth we don't really need for now. I believe we need something else. You need copper, bismuth, and and something else. I'm not sure what, though. Oh yeah, and hopefully I should have the Archimedes ships thing up and running soon. Obviously, it's going to be a long time before we can actually use them anyway, so I'm not in a massive rush to get them working. Okay, we can go explore a little bit, I guess. We can go try and find... Leave that there. We can go try and find somewhere to actually set up the farm. I get the feeling there might actually be some copper in this part of the mountain. I don't know, but I have a feeling. But we need a prospector's pick to find out, really. Okay, so I found somewhere which I think will be good to set up our first farm. It's kind of in between that mountain and the one we'll be going to. And there's a small lake here and a much bigger lake here, which will be good. I mean a much bigger lake. This one is huge. So we'll be able to switch when we want a bigger farm. We've got a massive area, which I'll probably fill in most of this with dirt so that we can expand. We have more room to work with, basically. So we're gonna hoe the ground first, get it set up, and then we're gonna have to run back to check on our metal. We can't hoe clay. This is where the dirt starts. So you can go 4 back from the water, I believe. If you don't know, you can... I'm going to have to change the mode quickly. Hang on. Controls. I mean, the button for mode. Where is it? Cycle tool mode. Oh, it's B. They've changed it to B. Okay. Cool. So, B. We'll go... This is basically tilling soil mode. This is checking hydration. If it's blue, then you've got hydration. If it's... Oh, it's still blue here. Aha, if it goes like that, then you don't have hydration. And that will go back to regular dirt. You can still hoe in hydration mode, which is good. And, oh, no, wrong button. And this is growth mode, so it will tell you how much the crops are, basically if they're grown or not, fully grown. There is another mode, which you can't access at the moment. I believe you either need a metal hoe, or you need a higher skill level. You need to be like an expert at agriculture to actually be able to use a different mode. It's the nutrients mode, so you'll be able to see which nutrients, or how much nutrients are left in the soil. Okay, so... it's getting dark. We need to head back, check on our metal, which is probably done. Cool, let's go. Actually, I'm going to leave some torches around. And quickly set a waypoint. Farm one, let's go. Oh, I need to drink. So hopefully the tool should be done and not solid. I did actually see yesterday, I was just exploring, I did see some zombies with pumpkins on their heads. Guess that's for Halloween, they usually do something like that, but I don't see them anymore, which is kind of strange. Maybe it was just one day only. Also found some more berry bushes, those are blackberry, I believe. Cool, it's done, let's break it and get our stuff. If we can, it's still liquid, good. So, saw mold is what we need. Fill it up and we're good. I'm going to go... Actually, I can put some stuff in this, can't I? That, and some stones. Cool, we definitely need this saw to make some chests and get organized. Let's break out the mold and put it with a stick, and we have a saw carpenter achievement. Why can't I relight torches? There we go. Cool. Do I have these? I do. Now we can actually make that bow that I was thinking of making. And so much other things, like chests, doors. In fact, why am I using these if I now have the ability to make a door? Let's do that first. So, stack of these. Crafted table, we need more than anything. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 of those make a crafting table and expands our crafting grid. There's a door. Awesome. We don't need these anymore. I'll just leave them there. Cool. So, deer tendons and a hammer turns them into fiber. In fact, I'm going to break these. Well, not break them, but put them into planks so we have more space. These are planks. Like, if you're new to Terraform Craft, these are, that's how you make like block planks. You can actually use this lumber to do things if you wanted to. You can place it like so and do some cool things like that. In fact, I might actually do that as a little trim around here. Maybe. Maybe. So, we need 6 of those to make a string, and we need 3 strings. So, we need 1 more deer tendon. There's none in there. I do have feathers, though, so we can take those to try and make some arrows. I'm just going to check if I have any more deer tendons. I'm pretty sure I kept them all in the same place, though. So, I'm going to wait till daytime. Then we're going to go and look for some more deer. I might actually cook this venison, because we need to preserve it a little bit more than we are at the moment. So, I'll be back when it's daytime. We can go try and make this bow. And in the next episode, I think we'll probably mess around with the saw and make a load of stuff. Maybe also try and look for some more copper, because, yeah, we definitely need some more. Okay, so we need to plant our seeds at the farm, and then we can head over somewhere, try and find some deer. I believe there was some where we were fighting bears. So let's plant everything. Obviously, just right click with the seeds on the tilled soil. If there's enough nutrients and water, you should be able to plant them. Maize there. Garlic. Soybeans. I'm not really organizing them at the moment. I'm just planting stuff. I don't really think there's any point in organizing them, because we'll be moving on to a different patch of soil once all this is grown. One thing we are missing, we don't have a lot of vegetables. We've got loads of onions, but not a lot of different kinds of vegetable. Tomatoes and onions, that's pretty much all we've got. I will need to plant some fruit trees as well somewhere. Cool. So also, get a few stones and sticks. Try and make some arrows. Hey. Cool. So to make arrows, normal arrows, you need stones, sticks, and feathers. You can make some arrows. 2 stacks should be enough. Hopefully, the longbow can shoot normal arrows. That would be nice. So, the deer, I believe, were over that way. We're going to head over there. There is a lot of ravines around here. Every time I want to go somewhere, I have to kind of dodge a ravine. I might check this one out quickly. No, there's nothing. Okay, so the bear, one of the bears, should be up here. Yep. Hello, friend. There should be some deer somewhere around here. Actually, I did have an idea. I kind of want to make a little home for some bears. Try and trap 2 or 3 in a home. If I keep hitting them every time I walk past them, they might not like me in the end, but I think that might be a good idea. Cool, we got some deer. I need a weapon. Okay. Axe and knife will have to do. Drop tendons. Did he drop tendon? He did. We got one. That's all we need. So I will leave you. Also, I'm going to grab some of this sugar cane because I don't... It takes so long to grow, but I don't want to... I don't want to let it despawn because then we might not ever get sugar cane again. And sugar's good for making rum. And you can also use it for other things, I believe. Cool, so let's make that longbow. Deer tendon, hammer, sinew fiber, and then six of those makes a sinew string. And was it three of them? Makes a sinew bowstring. Then we need a log and a knife. Bow limb. Yeah, baby. Longbow. Awesome. Does it shoot arrows? It does shoot normal arrows. Takes a long time to draw back, but that's TFC. Cool. How far does it shoot? Let's try and shoot that tree over there. Okay, that dropped a lot. But it's a weapon. It's definitely better than hitting people with a stone axe. So we're going to go try and try it out on the bear, maybe. I'm so evil to these bears, but... They're not nice creatures. Yeah, that dropped a lot and went to the right a little bit. So it's not very accurate at long range, but that was really long range. Target practice. Oh, I killed the bear. Okay. I guess it does quite a lot of damage then. Because, well, he would have been low health, but... I don't want to kill all the bears, though. I'm going to leave this one, because I want them... I want to make a home for them, like a little bear cage. And if any animals... I don't know, we can just feed them animals. Cool, so... Yeah, I think that's pretty much all we got time for in this episode. I'm going to try out the longbow a bit more when it's nighttime. We'll shoot some zombies and stuff. Still no sugar from these things, even though they look quite grown. Thought that was something more exciting than zombie flesh, but no. Cool, so I'm going to go back to the base. In the next episode, we'll probably... Play around with the saw, make some chests, try and make some extra space in our little starter shack. Oh, really? Really? There's another copper nugget there. And another one there. I guess that's kind of good. Now we are at 50 units for the next tool. So we only need 50 more. I think the next tool we're going to make is going to be the prospector's pick. Definitely need one of those, and then it will be a sword, I think, or some kind of weapon. Anyway, that is all we got time for in this episode. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I shall... Well, actually, no. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to leave a like. It really helps me out, helps the channel grow. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.